when I go somewhere, the Uber driver's talking, and you know, inevitably they ask, well, what do you do? And I say, I'm a teacher. They go, oh, and they have, you know, their reaction. And a lot of times they're like, well, why? And I always ask them, well, like, who is your favorite teacher? 99% of the time, they're able to name the person. And 99% of the time, they smile. I don't know another profession other than like being a superhero, I guess, that could do that. I teach here at Valor College Prep. I teach 11th grade AP US History. At Valor, the focus is much more so on social and emotional learning, teaching students how to like basically like navigate the onslaught of emotions and feelings that they're experiencing every single day, along with traditional math, science, social studies.
Kick us off, Jester.
Hi, my name is Jester. I'm feeling kind of nervous today. Valor is, in a word, unique. So Circle, the best way that I've come to describe it is it's halfway between a group therapy session and an AA meeting.
Circle basically is about like a 55-minute experience where students will sit together and basically take the time to share how they're feeling.
I'm feeling kind of worried today.
I'm feeling a little bit stressed, but mostly excited.
I'm feeling a mix of like stress, but as well as like kind of at peace.
It's a moment for us to decompress and focus in on how we're doing emotionally and give us just that sort of safe space to just be a collective individually.
What if I don't get the scholarship I had before and I have to like actually like, you know, pull weight a lot more? Because I didn't study and I regret it a lot because I feel like I should have listened to my mom when she told me.
So I definitely understand like the idea of like procrastinating, but I definitely feel like that same pressure you're under, like wanting to do like really well so you can apply to college and get your scholarships and everything. I also resonate with like the fact of like how like your mom was saying, like making sure you study. Also kind of did the same thing with mine.
On our best days, I truly have seen like students like look out for one another and make connections that I think every teacher and member of a school like hopes to see.
Expressing my worries about school and the stress and like the overwhelming feelings that I usually have throughout the day in class, I think talking about those are pretty relieving because you realize that almost everybody's feeling the exact same way.
I shared last year, my 10th grade year. It was my first time in front of everybody. Like, I was nervous. You just like getting put on the spotlight, basically. You just talking and people are just listening to you and looking at you. So I was telling my teacher, like, I didn't want to do it.
You're supposed to have them share out their basically like their feelings, their emotions, their struggles. A student isn't going to do that unless they trust you. And to do that is a feat. But if you do it well, the reward is astronomical.
I personally really disliked it as a middle schooler. I just really didn't think sitting down talking about my feelings was important. But over time, throughout the years, I started to realize that it was actually something that was like useful to me.
People know who I am today, like at Valor. They know what I went through and everything.
The hardest part is being vulnerable, but in almost every circle I've ever been in, vulnerability is always met with support.
I'm able to trust more with people that I love, like my friends.
Even if we don't understand what a teenager is going through, to say, you know, it is tough, your feelings are valid. For a student to hear that from a teacher, like they actually care about them as a human being, what I've seen happen is students start to excel.
There's more to life than all this. You know, there's a lot of stress in school, and I realized I was kind of working myself to death. This is my life. No one can take that away from me. So what I've been doing for the past couple of days is just, you know, just appreciating the things in life that I have.
So I want to appreciate Chris. It's like, how are you even the same person right now? You have just taken such an initiative and said, I'm not just going to sit here, I'm going to do everything I can to be the person I want to be.
Once you see students like open up, it's like, this is everything that we've been trying to do. And like for one brief magical moment, students get to feel like whole. I think without recognizing students as whole humans with desires and dreams and setbacks and obstacles, then we're truly missing out on half of a student.
Y'all ready?
My name is Natalie Nikitas, and this is my brief but spectacular take on building trust in a circle.